Hello, hello, Spear here, back again with more American Truck Simulator. Back on the road again. On the road again. Whoops, why did I hit drive? I shouldn't have hit drive, but oh well. We need a job. Get some work to do. We are free as the wind. That's not going to bring in the bacon, is it? We need to make some money. Check out some more of this lovely Washington and Oregon area. So, of course, the first thing I do is click drive, where I'm going to have to not drive, but actually have to find a job. Last time, of course, we came to this rail yard. Bing! Let's try to find our way out of here without crashing. Always the challenge. Check here and see if they've got a job for us right here, because that would be perfect. Wouldn't it? That's what we always like, a job right here. We go to Burns. Where's Burns? I don't want to go to Fresno. Burns, not too far. Spokane? Ooh, we haven't been there. Or San Rafael? Oh, man. It's only 7,000, 15,000 of Burns. Oh, I like that. Do like 15,000, and the lumber sounds like that's gonna be a good looking truck. But I feel like we've already gone down this one. Okay, let's head on back. See anything on my GPS yet. Here it is. Oh, that is interesting. Look at that. I feel like we might have done one of these before. That doesn't mean it's no fun. Going down to Burns, Montgomery Burns. Oh yeah, good camera view. You always gotta check out the different camera views. See what you get. Nice. Cool, well, let me change camera view here. Check out the back of this thing. The wood doesn't go all the way to the end. It's got a, whoops. So I wonder if I could steer out of here like this. I do like camera view 8. I turn here on. I do like this camera view, even though sometimes it's very difficult, because you get far away like this and it's like, oh my goodness, like I can't really see what's in front of me here or how close I am to that building, but that's, it gives you a cool shot, exactly what's going on. You know, in a movie when you get a big pan, you know, they do that. Cool, cool, cool. All right, I gotta check the map. We're coming out. Getting right on 82, the interstate, going over to 84. And down twisty 395. All right, good, good, good. Let's get in the truck.
Turn right.
Yes, ma'am.
Turn right.
I'm gonna do it. I'm not gonna pull in there, though. I mean, that's... Well, that's science, kind of. heading off to the right here. Taco Mexican restaurant. Orders to go. So I probably should stop in and get something to go. It's 4 in the afternoon. 84 degrees. Fairly full tank of fuel. No idea how much sleep we need. Pretty sure we've been sleeping at night, but I feel like I might have accidentally done a double. Am I going to the right or the left up here?
Keep right.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, 82. 82 east, that's what we're doing. Kind of work. Yeah, I mean, this is, look at this. This is a type of intersection you've not seen before. Giant pound there. What's going on now? I'm afraid to get up too fast here, because I don't really know what's going on. You'd hate to suddenly be surprised by a sharp turn. There's all kinds of weird roads going in at weird angles here. You guys in Washington might be able to shed some more light on that. Oh, and here's the ETS2 style. Oh, no, it's not. It does give me a tiny bit of entrance lane. Oh, gee. I was not expecting that charger to pop up. Oh. It's not making any sudden moves. I'm wondering if I need to do something about trailer stability. I mean, I don't want it to be ridiculously just stuck to that road, but feels like it just totally bounces around like crazy, dude. So that any quick input on the steering wheel has the potential of rolling me. Alright, 82 to 84, then to that state route down the twisty bit. Oh no, the twisty bit. We've been down, we've been up the twisty bit. And it was very scary. Uh-oh. So, we shall see. Don't wait me. Don't wait me. Let me out. I don't know if you've been looking at the signs. You can read them as much as I can. Way station. I don't have time for this. I've got a schedule to keep.
Never mind. I'll find a new route.
Thanks for that. Down. Now, unfortunately, I've put the keyboard in such a place where I can't get to it right now. Otherwise, I would have changed back to camera view 2 or 8. Darn it! Think, Spear, think!
Porsche, please watch the speed.
What now? What has happened here? Everybody stopped like it's some kind of accident? Oh no. I cannot. Yeah, there's been an accident. These two guys came together. And they will never move. Yep, see, look at that. They'll just sit there. Smart move, Spear. See, now when you play a long time, you get to recognize those kinds of things. That it's not just your normal, everyday merging backup. I looked at the truck that was in the lead, and it was at an odd angle. It would not have had its front of the truck in the road there. So, yeah. Sometimes you gotta pass it like that. Alright. But it's gonna make up some good time here. La 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 la. Sunshine Crocs. between a rock and a hard place there. Couldn't stop. Had a car coming up quick on my left and that big old truck coming up on my right. And if you need to, rewind the video and check it out. But they're trying to crush me. Sometimes there's nothing you can do. The entrance acceleration lanes are not long enough. And I don't know why. Welcome to Oregon. Back in Oregon. It's getting a little... It's only 6 o'clock, but it feels like it's getting dark. Some of these signs. Okay, I don't feel like I want to take this very quick. Oh, come on. Why do they always send cars up when you need to get over? You know, there's two ways of thinking that. You only notice it when you need to get over, so it just seems like they really do that. Or maybe they really do that. To make it seem like there's more traffic and more challenge. Who knows? Alright, Pendleton is where we get on 395 south, I believe. Or maybe not. Are we not taking 395 south? Not been to Pendleton before, so I'm not particularly familiar with it. The trucks around this part don't seem to go the speed limit. In this part of the map. Oh boy. I tell you what, the merging is I guess the scariest part of driving. Because you just know they're going to do it sometime. But when?
Keep right and then exit right.
Okay. 395 south of Pendleton.
Exit. Right.
As predicted. Ta-da! Spear's
keep
no
right,
dummy.
And then turn right.
You might be thinking, ah, Spear, he's a dummy. He's no dummy.
Turn right.
No, I'm turning. I don't want to just blow through this red light. Even though I could have, I didn't want to. Alright, I'm going to stay in this lane. I'm going to assume other lane merges. Because this looked like a very twisty and slow going road, and it looks like I'll be hitting it. What the? What? Are those polar bears standing outside the. What did we see the other day? Was it a cow? Some kind of steer maybe? No, I don't know what it was. Yeah, see, it's like that lane merges. And here we go. Down this tight road as night is coming. So be concerned. Be very concerned. What do horses do at night? TV and the movies, you always see they go into a bar. They go into a barn in the storms. They just hang outside all night? There's cows. Huh. I gotta admit, I don't know a lot about livestock and other farm animals. Are horses considered livestock? I don't think so. Livestock, just by the name of it, implies that those are the animals that we're going to be eating. Well, now wait a second. It's breeding stock. I don't know. Watch out for deer. See, now that would be cool. Can there please be deer crossing the road? Although, you know, there's probably not deer crossing the road because people would try to hit them. I was thinking it could be like the tumbleweeds, because you hit the tumbleweeds a lot in, what is that, Nevada? Maybe in Arizona too? But, so you know, they could just use the same mechanic for deer, but I'm guessing people would try to be silly. And they don't want a game where people are actively trying to mow down deer. That would not be a good look for the game. But it would make the map more lifelike to have some animals. Okay, so I could be going much faster. Speed limit's 55, but this is a twisty road. Visibility is not so good. If you're looking at it and you're saying, gee, Spear, it's a little hard to see. I'm like, yeah. Yeah, it is. I cut the corner just to avoid having to turn too sharply. Thankfully, they're on the other side. The lightning came right when I turned on my brights. I guess it was lightning. Maybe that was my brakes lighting up the countryside. Doesn't feel like my brights are on. This isn't really night. This is just dark from rain. Yeah, so it's lightning. Jeez. That's freaking me out. I would not like driving this truck on this road in this rain at this time. I don't even like doing it in the sim. Some kind of national park. Malheur National Forest. Sorry, not national park. Unlike ETS-2, oh, there is a bend, okay. Whew. I was gonna say,
get
I like
to turn left.
The gas stations here are not sleeping areas. There's nowhere in ATS to sleep at a gas station. Gas stations are for gas. Yes, yes. But there is a motel up here on the right. I think it's a motel. Some might just be a. Oh, the wood's getting all wet. Here we go, rest area. Haven't been in here before. I don't know if there's a special lane for trucks. No, it just looks like it's a big parking lot. I don't know where I can see. I can't see any stripes. Just says sleep anywhere. Okay. Good sleep. Let's see if I can wait, what was that? Oh, I pressed the wrong button before. This camera. My rear's sticking out a little bit there, but that's alright. You hear the rain? That's nice. Alright. It's pretty soggy out there, so we're going to rest here for the night. Join me next time so we continue this load of lumber. Load of lumber. Try saying that 6 times fast. Down to Burns, Oregon. Montgomery boy. Oi, hoi. We'll do that next time. Thanks for watching this episode of American Truck Simulator. See you next time.